Oh, it's a studio with a reading from the collective. Take what resonates throughout the rest. I hope that everyone is very, very well. Ooh. Very obsessive person who is very corrupt here. Whoa. Getting exposed, this person. It's exposed. Nine of Pentacles reverse. A lie has come out. Whatever they were paying attention to, someone investigated, took a deep look at that. Wow, it's over for this person. Or someone feels very betrayed by what they did. Someone feels very passionate about this. All right, so what do we need to know? What does the collective need to know? Okay, so there's a King of Cups here, masculine energy in the upright. This is someone who has a lot of emotions that they stuff down, or they're good at controlling their feelings. They're the King of Cups, so they are a leader. They have a lot of emotions, but they keep them down, or they've mastered them. This could be someone who, you know, is someone's love. Wow. Devil. Wow, Page of Swords. So this is in the challenge position. We just saw this energy. And Page of Swords. Someone's spying on someone, or gossip, spying, slander. Something's happening that feels faded. Around this Queen of Wands. So. Okay. This King of Cups could feel spied upon. Wow, in the subconscious. Five of Swords. Someone's feeling in the subconscious like there's someone here who will do anything to win. A real bully. Very aggressive, or like conflict is about to erupt. Someone's keeping their wits about them in this situation. They feel like someone's obsessed and watching them. They feel subconsciously like someone wants to attack them or something, or they're dealing with someone who is going to go farther than even what appears. I mean, Devil is already pretty intense there. That's as shadowy as one can get. So a very shadowy person, gossip, spies, slander, stalking. Someone's feeling stalked. There's someone who's obsessed here who wants to win it at any cost. Someone might have taken a break in the recent past. They might have gone on vacation. They might have needed the time to retreat. They could not have been feeling well. They could have been taking the time to reflect. They could have tuned in to meditate, whatever version of meditation that is for them. Wow. Seven of Swords. They have to deal with this Seven of Swords. And also what's sticking out to me is this Nine of Swords. And potentially this Page of Cups. But I'm going to put it back. No, I'm going to keep it. A nightmare. A lie. A lie that is a nightmare. A complete and total nightmare. And reflecting on love. They have to deal with this. There is someone lying, cheating, stealing that is such a nightmare. It's something about expressing their feelings, or a message of love, or unconditional love, or sensitive feelings around love. Something about this is like a nightmare. In the near future. Seven of Pentacles. Someone will be taking a moment to step back from the efforts that they've been putting time, money, energy into something. Sometimes that card is failure, and that's why they have to take a step back, or they decide it's failure, or it's a redo, something has to be redone. The lens this person is looking through, what they're seeing, what is this person seeing? Eight of Cups, so this could be them themselves. They could be this person in this little red cloak walking across, leaving these cups behind. They thought there was something in these cups. There's nothing coming out of these cups. So they've got to find more meaning in their life. There's no meaning here. This is meaningless. They need to move on in order to find meaning. And it's a journey. They've got to go on a journey. This is about mastery. Eights are about mastery. These are cups, so it's emotions. Mastering something up within themselves. I feel like that's why they want to be this King of Cups. Something, I feel like there have been tower moments. I feel like they're feeling spied upon, or like there's someone here who's very obsessed with them. They feel something under the surface, like something's about to happen, like they're dealing with someone who isn't, there's not a full deck there, or there's something insidious or something like that going on beyond this obsession. It's like, okay. Or they, you know, they could feel this about themselves, like they got in this position because of their aggression, or because of their need to win so badly that now here they are. So there's a part of them that could be blaming themselves, that they missed this devil here. It's now very glaring. Very glaring. I feel like it's a haunting feeling. I feel like divine feminine energies or feminine energies who've been dealing with this know what this feels like. Three of Wands in the environment. Someone could be traveling. They could be looking out. This person could be traveling alone. They could have decided to take this break. We could be on a break now. Everyone could know that they're traveling. They could be traveling alone. If this is not about traveling, this is about someone who is already in the environment, who's already taken the steps, or is looking forward out into the future based on what they've, the actions that they've taken, the choices they've made. It feels optimistic. It's all about pursuing desires, passion, energy, a life force, following inspiration, taking the steps through to follow inspiration. There's someone in the environment that's doing that. As I was looking at that, I saw Queen of Wands. So I feel like that's you. I feel like that's you. The Moon, Queen of Pentacles, hopes and fears. I feel like they feel confused about who you are. Or, yeah. They don't understand you. Or there's some kind of deception or illusion. They're afraid. They could even be afraid of you. I don't know. I gotta clarify that outcome. I think they should be more afraid of this energy. Bondage, obsession, materialism, addictions, shadow behavior, shadow side, stalking. Stalking, an obsessive stalker, I would say that's The Fool. Someone's going to take a leap of faith. That's the outcome. Someone's going to take a leap of faith with innocence, an innocent energy. Fools are usually protected when they're in the upright. King of Pentacles, Wheel of Fortune. This could be another masculine energy. Something's happening that's destined or fated. Very clearly fated. There could be someone here who's a master manifester. It's all about manifestation, fate, karma. A lot of it has to do with someone sitting on the fence for too long, making a decision by not making one at all. But there's something here. There could be another masculine energy who, I mean, this could be like an Archangel Michael hero energy from the ethers. This could be this person getting clarity of thought. A lot of clarity. When someone has the most clarity of thought, or they master the mind, they are balanced, they will, with a bird's eye view, err on the side of justice and truth. So whoever this is, that's what this is. There could be someone here who... It could be this person wants to be more just, or there could be, I feel like there could be two other masculine energies in the mix here. So let's see, what else do we need to know about this energy? The other thing is this King of Cups could be very shifty and merciless and cold and hide it really well. And they could be the stalker, obsessed stalker energy who wants to win at all costs. And they are in a lot of anxiety about how to move forward, about a lie that they told, and apologize. Wow. And then they will be planning whatever that is soon. They've got to walk away from whatever situation, or they're looking at someone walking away. That could be you. They see your ships coming in. They could be very confused by you. Maybe they feel they underestimated who you are. They don't really know, feel like they know you the way that they thought that they did. King of Cups. Or this is a karmic feminine stalking this person who's trying to right themselves. We'll see. Let's clarify. What do we need to know about this King of Cups, please? Number four. A message. This is the message song. They received a message that clarified something for them. They want to send a message. There's something they're watching, reading, a document. There's something important here for this person that is pertinent. Just change the battery. Devil, Page of Swords. This could also be a message, by the way, an obsessive message. This person could be getting Thief reverse. Yeah, this is some obsessed person, really shockingly disturbed. Thief reverse, letting go of this stalker who's stalking them. Someone's stealing, someone's a thief. Thief reverse. Someone's obsessed because they're being let go. A spiritual pickpocket. Five of Swords in the subconscious. Occupation. They either feel like this person's going to try to attack what they do for a living, or they feel like they got themselves into this situation because they wanted to win at all costs in their occupation. Four of Swords, they've been really thinking, they've taken the time on this journey. This is either them going on a trip, like a retreat by themselves, to really think something through, or with a few people, just to get a break. This could even be some kind of like a place to rehabilitate. This could be an emotional journey that is at home. A staycation, a place to think about their life, to really go inwards and reflect. So it's a trip, a physical trip, or it's internal. Either way, it's the same energy. Someone could be messaging them on this trip, or there's a message. I feel like someone could be pinging someone a lot. I don't know why I use the word ping. Pinging. Texting, a lot of texts. Someone's trying to let go of something, someone or something. Or they're disturbed by what this person did. There's a message they read, or a message they got, or some information that's very pertinent in regards to this shadowy, obsessive, stalker. Someone stole something, or time, money, energy, or whatever it is. They could lack the capacity to feel. They could lack the empathy gene, I mean to say. So now, Seven of Swords, Nine of Swords, there's a lie, a terrible lie, that's a nightmare. Child reverse, Page of Cups. So this could have to do with a child, something having happened to a child. A child might not be someone's, or how they're gonna move forward, because they have a child, they might end up, what are they gonna do? Especially if this person is very off balance. Page of Cups, they could feel terrible because someone could not have a child because of something that happened. There could be a lack of innocence, and they feel a nightmare about how to apologize, or someone who is innocent could have been hurt. So I'll clarify again, but let's move on to Seven of Pentacles. Someone is focused in on something and working through what to do. Thoughts. Planning. They're planning something about their time. They're taking a step back to look and see. Someone is looking in deeply. They've been thinking. This is all thinking and observing and being. There's something about letting go of this thief, or someone is stalking someone. Eight, they've got to walk away, or they're on a trip, they're walking away. Sudden wealth, something they thought was like, you know, that the universe was raining down money and potential on them, because they might have gotten into this situation because it was all about money or achievement. They're going to have to walk away from the idea of what that is. But then they see this Queen of Wands seems to have their eye on something here. Mean male reverse. There's a mean male here. I feel like this is someone who's very sketchy, that somehow is involved here in someone's eye on the prize, something that some creation or someone's vision. But this person is still in the upright, and that's very clear that there's someone who's very sketchy. Queen of Wands, very warm, passionate, enigmatic, feminine energy. Something to do with this sketchy masculine person is in their environment that everyone can see. The Moon, someone's confused. Maybe they're confused about who this thief was, or they're deceiving. They want to deceive someone about despair. It's not about they want to get out of despair. They want to get out of despair, or they're confused. How did this Queen of Pentacles get out of this despair? Or they're confused about a Queen of Pentacles, and they don't want to be in despair. Or they don't want to be in despair about the illusion that they were in or are in. but they can't be anymore because it's a lie. It's very clearly a lie that someone's a thief and a liar. The Fool. Someone's gonna take a leap of faith. They're gonna marriage reverse. I feel like they're gonna, whatever this is, it's gonna get dissolved. Privileged Lady reverse under the deck. I feel like they feel like whoever this was not a privileged lady. Like they might have thought they were. And that's why maybe they feel duped or something. Let's clarify Moon. I'm just gonna use these. Unless they feel like you are that Queen of Pentacles and they just don't understand you. They don't understand maybe how you see what you see, or you know what you know, or how you dealt with whatever it is that this karmic feminine was doing to you. I'm not really sure, so let's use the cards. Let's go through the whole thing once. So, message of concern. What is... This person received a message, or they're seeing something very clearly. Curious about you. This says, like, stalking energy. A message about someone just very... Someone... They don't want someone to keep stalking someone, or they don't want to be stalked. Curious about you. Turned upside down. Don't be curious about me, or don't be curious about them. A message. Stop it. Don't do this. Beef reverse. Caught a case. I feel like this has to do with not like physical disease. I feel like this has to do with they feel like there's someone who's attached to them that is obsessed. That they got themselves involved in something where someone is like caught a case, like they caught a case, like they caught someone in their life that they made a choice to get involved in a situation, and now it's like this person is disturbed. They have someone who's disturbed in their life that is now going to be obsessed with them and could try to destroy them now. And that's the case they caught. I feel like that's what it is. Occupation, Five of Swords, this bully. Occupation, someone tried to bully someone out of their work, or this person feels like this person's gonna do this, how to get out of this nightmare. They feel like this person's gonna try to destroy them, I feel like. Or they got themselves into this nightmare for wanting to win so bad that they didn't see this. I'm not gonna clarify journey, I know what that is. What is this child here for? Grudge holder. If they have a child, they're not sure what to do about the child. Or will someone hold a grudge because of a child? They lied. Maybe this person lied. They were not honest. They were emotionally an emotional cheater. They got into something when it was a lie. And now, show me more. Grudge holder. Seven of Swords. A lie that's a nightmare. They lied. Maybe they lied and they got themselves into a nightmare. Ego. They're worried about someone's ego. Ego getting in the way. Someone's not into someone. Someone's not always partying. Someone's not unbothered. Grudges and egos. Someone's worried. There's a nightmare about someone's grudge and an ego problem. Something about someone who doesn't always party. and someone's not into someone, and someone's not unbothered. Something about, I guess that's a sore point, partying, how much someone parties or doesn't party. Egos are involved. It could have to do with a child. Someone's not into someone, someone doesn't want to party, they're not unbothered by that. Something about this child. Still not really sure. One more. Ego is involved. Why is the child there? It has to do with innocence. It has to do with you. Someone's really bothered by you. Someone's ego is involved. Someone's holding a grudge in regards to you. I feel like it's the fact that you don't party? I don't know why that's a thing. I'm not really sure why that's a thing. Maybe you're more balanced or the right place for the, they feel like you, something about their, maybe you have a child with this person? Or it's like the better place for the child. Someone wants to go somewhere. They lied. They should have. An ego, grudge, child. Something to do with you. But you are like in the upright. Someone's not unbothered. There's someone holding a grudge. It's all about ego. It's a nightmare. This big lie. Someone's gotta think something through in the near future. Seven of coins. They've gotta think through karma. What they did, how they participated. Because of wanting to win at all costs. They've gotta walk away. It's not, they feel like they're losing. They're losing the jackpot. Main nail is here. This sketchy masculine, the other one, is running from what they did to you in regards to you waiting for your ships to come in. Something you were working on creating, or your vision, or something like that. What is this? Someone's trying to get out of despair. They're confused. Something to do with a love triangle and a child. Something about, why is this Queen of Pentacles here? If it's not a child, it could have to do with, like, how they got themselves here, or, I mean, child neglect. It could be a child, a love triangle, trying to get out of despair in regards to this problem with the child. They're very confused about this Queen of Pentacles. Or they're some sort of an illusion. I feel like they don't understand you. I don't know, that's all I can get out of that. The Fool. Someone's gonna take a leap of faith out of this situation. They're gonna start over. They wanna become untrapped. Tripping on you. And probably looking you up. But I feel like they're really confused about you, what you're doing, who you are, what you're doing, how you, confused about you. I think even spooked a little bit, how you know what you know, who you are, something about a child, how maybe you knew something in it, I don't know. We'll leave it at that. If you resonate, I hope that it helps, and I'll see you on the next one. Bye.